you know, just going by the aromas that are emanating from this pot. The biryani is steaming hot inside.
Hi folks, welcome to another episode of Gourmet On The Road, and we are right now negotiating traffic in Bengaluru. It's a Friday afternoon and I've just stepped out of my office to try and score some biryani. Now it so happens that Bakri Eid is just around the corner, a few days away, and I'm hoping that you get to see this video before Bakri Eid. Well, on Bakri Eid I will typically go to a Muslim friend's house and eat some delicious biryani. And as I was thinking of this biryani that I would be eating on Bakri Eid, I suddenly had this craving to taste some good Muslim style biryani, the kind of biryani that you would eat in someone's home on Bakri Eid. So I put up a post on Facebook to find out which restaurant serves up a good Muslim style biryani, and I got a number of responses, and thank you very much to all of you who responded to my query. And of the many responses that I received, I've zeroed in on this restaurant called Chichaba's Taj. Now this restaurant's lineage goes back many years to another popular restaurant called Taj, which is perhaps about 60-70 odd years old. I don't know exactly how many years. Chichaba's Taj is a recent offshoot of the iconic Taj, and I'm told it's named after the owner or the founder of the legendary Taj. So that's where we are headed to taste what will hopefully be great biryani. Janab Abdul Rahman, who was known as Chichaba. So he was the one who started Taj Hotel in Shivaji Nagar. It's just about 3 and therefore the restaurant is empty, but I can smell biryani in the air. So I think we made a good choice in coming to this place. Hame biryani try karna hai.
Try
kiya sir. Ha, to mutton biryani aur chicken biryani bhi try karenge. I'm going to taste both the chicken and the mutton biryani. But then when you come here and you smell all this food, and you look at the menu, you start wanting other things. ठीक है, तो एक काम करेंगे, एक चिचाबाज़ फ्राइड चिकन देना, एक सीख कबाब, ठीक है? Thank you. Always a good sign when the plate arrives on the table. You know the food is not far behind.
Green mint chutney.
Mint chutney, सीख कबाब. So that's the चिचाबाज़ फ्राइड चिकन, and then you have the सीख कबाब. So there you go, I have my Seekh Kebab and the Chichaba special chicken. I'm going to taste the chicken first, because when you taste the mutton, I think the chicken always has a tough act to follow. So in Bengaluru, we love our chicken kebabs, and the chicken kebabs that we love in Bengaluru are the fried kebabs, the ones that are deep fried. And then you have this glorious fiery red looking kebab. Let's taste this Chichaba special chicken kebab. Sometimes the chicken, it can go very dry. But this chicken is soft and almost juicy, and I think it's made very well. It's succulent, if I could use that word for this piece of chicken. So you look at this piece of chicken, you see that the marinade has penetrated deep inside the chicken, making it a flavorful bite. You know, nothing as comforting as eating onions in between kebabs. It just kind of refreshes the palate, moistens the palate. I also like the crunch of the masala. I'm going to taste it with the curry leaf. To be honest, I'm not a big fan of deep fried kebabs, but this one is quite interesting. I think it's a good kebab to keep you occupied while you wait for that biryani. Speaking of kebabs, I must now taste the mutton seekh kebab. Now the mutton seekh kebab is a specialty of the original Taj restaurant along with the biryanis. It's been a while since I've tasted it, so I'm quite curious to know what this will taste like. As I break into that seekh kebab, you can see all that juiciness ooze out. And the thing with the seekh kebab, because there's some fat in it with the mince, you've got to eat it as soon as it is served, because that's really when you taste the juiciness of the kebab.
I'm told this kebab is grilled on a sigri. So the outer layer of the seekh has a nice crust and it's got this flavorful mutton mince inside. You definitely taste the flavor of the meat and the fat that's been mixed into the meat. When I'm tasting kebabs, I like to taste the kebab just by itself. Of course, you have the mint yogurt chutney here that I can use with the kebab, but I like to taste the flavor of the meat just by itself. And I think that's what makes it interesting. What I also like here is the spicing of the kebab. So while it looks fiery red, on the palate, the kebab is quite gentle. Some onion just to break the taste of the kebab on my palate. I like these tangy, spiced onions. So you got the chili heat and you also got a bit of tang. And I think that probably comes from the lime.
Halfway through tasting the kebabs, I decided to order a couple of other dishes that came highly recommended on the Chichaba's menu. The Paya, Bheja fry and the very popular Barrah kebab.
It certainly smells aromatic. You have the peppery notes of the soup and then you have that zesty freshness of the coriander that's used as garnish. So you've got all this gelatin that's been rendered into this broth. And I think that's what makes it so nourishing as a soup. So the gelatin and the trotter have rendered beautifully. So it's soft and yet mildly flavorful. If I wasn't going to eat my biryani, I would probably ask for some bread to dunk into this paya and mop it all up. I'm going to rein back my appetite or my greed and also taste a bit of the bheja fry that has also landed on our table. This feels soft to the touch. You have all that unctuous, creamy richness of the bheja or the goat brain that just coats your palate. And then I've got a crispened curry leaf that's cresting this luscious piece of brain. This is going to be one lush mouthful. I can feel it dissolve in my mouth. That custardy creaminess of the goat brain of the bheja has permeated every pore of my palate. And that's really what I taste. Well, I was talking to one of the chaps out here and they said they do a good Barrah kebab. So I said, well, before the biryani, perhaps I'll taste one of the Barrah kebabs and see what this Barrah kebab is all about here. This Barrah kebab peels away almost effortlessly from the bone. Yet has the right amount of bite, allowing you to chew on it. You know, you want your meat to have a bit of a bite. You want to feel like you're eating meat. And this kebab is grilled to perfection. I love these burnt ends of the kebab because you've got all the flavors in the meat that have caramelized into that burnt end. And sometimes that's a tasty part of the kebab. So there's a smoky note, there is the mellow spicing of the kebab and the bite of the meat that you have on your palate as you taste this Barrah kebab. This is certainly a tasty kebab. I had to get these pictures. What's arrived on the table is the reason why we are here at Chichaba's. So we've got the biryanis here. So I have the chicken biryani right here. And I have the mutton biryani. And of course the biryani is served with a baigan ka salan and some salad to go with it. I'm going to begin with the chicken biryani first. So this biryani here is made with the short grain jeera sambar rice. So there you go, I've got a piece of chicken right here. It has a nice, gentle aroma. Not the sort of biryani that you will smell from half a block away, but it has that mild, gentle aroma. And the rice, each grain of rice is separate, which is also the hallmark of a good biryani. And the rice feels nice and warm to the touch. Enough said, time to taste the biryani now. This is a mild biryani. Let's taste some of the meat. Taste some of the meat with the rice. Just get a bit of that masala to lift the flavors of the rice. Mix it all up nicely. You know, this biryani has tomatoes in it, so it kind of has that hint of tartness. And of course, you've got the fresh flavors of the herbs that have gone into this again. The masala is nice and mellow. It's gentle. It's not the sort of biryani that will jolt your senses, but it's a very mellow, sort of a gently flavored sort of a biryani. There's little pockets of masala that you see in the rice, and you should mix your rice into that. And that's really when you get the complete flavor of this biryani. The chicken is cooked fine. It's not the juiciest of birds, perhaps, but with the rice, it makes for a flavorful bite. Enough said about the chicken. Let's move on to the mutton dum biryani. You know, just going by the aromas that are emanating from this pot, even as I unsettle the biryani to get the rice onto my plate and also the piece of meat, I can definitely sense by the aromas that are wafting out of this pot that this is going to be flavorful biryani as compared to the chicken biryani. I need to gently nudge a piece of the meat onto my plate. The biryani is steaming hot inside. So the rice is warm on the outside, but inside it contains these hot pieces of mutton. Oh, this is hot. I'm going to taste the rice just by itself first. With due apologies to all the chicken lovers out there, I think there's nothing that comes close to a good mutton biryani. I've got this plump piece of meat and the meat is hot. I'm going to take the meat, going to take some masala and a bit of the rice. I'm sure this is going to be a happy mouthful. What I really appreciate about this biryani are the mellow flavors. This certainly feels like a biryani that will leave you satisfied, but happily so, without too many of the unsavory side effects of consuming all that meat and rice. The masala is mellow and then you have that gentle undercurrent of tartness that comes from the tomato. Now, so this meat also has a bit of fat. You need the fat to convey all those flavors. And there's a lot of the flavor that's there in the fat. I'm going to have some of that biryani rice. See, there's a cardamom here. With some of that baigan ka salan on my plate. The sourness in the baigan salan lends a whole new dimension to the biryani. It suddenly makes it livelier. So if you like your biryani mellow, gentle, have the biryani as it is. Maybe go for those pockets of masala, you know, with a little bit of the tomato, with a little bit of the spices, and mix it well into your rice just to give it that slight flavor oomph. But if you like something really robust, if you like something very sprightly, take some of that baigan ka salan and mix that into your rice for a flavorful mouthful. There's the last piece of meat before I wrap up. I like the fact that they're quite generous with the meat here. So you got the meat and you also have a bit of fat in every bite, because it's the fat that conveys the flavor of the meat. Well, I set out to film this episode on the back of a biryani craving. And the biryani that I've just tasted, especially the mutton biryani here at Chichaba Taj, has certainly quelled that craving. And I know that I'm going to be back not just for the mutton biryani, but also that Barrah kebab and that creamy custardy Bheja pepper fry. So until the next episode of Gourmet on the Road, stay safe and happy eating.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating!